Before diving into federated consensus, we're going to refresh ourselves with the definitions of all the terminology we've picked up thus far. Remember that a quorum in a distributed system is a set of nodes sufficient to reach agreement. In PBFT, that's over two-thirds of the voters. We refer to this as a Byzantine agreement within a BFT consensus algorithm. Let's say you're part of a decentralized, distributed network, but you still can't choose which nodes to trust. How can you and your peers still come to consensus without relying on a central party to dictate the truth? This is where the concept of a federated Byzantine agreement comes in. Rather than relying on a central actor to choose quorums for us or to decide the truth for us, we can individually select who we trust using a quorum slice. This is a subset of a quorum that can convince a particular node, aka you, of agreement. Individual nodes can decide who to include within their quorum slice. Let's say you're the purple node, the leftmost of the set of four nodes. You believe a crayon to be red. The other nodes, who happen to be in your quorum slice, tell you that the crayon is actually green. Because you have decided to trust them, you change your opinion, instead coming to consensus with them that the crayon is, in fact, green. You then celebrate and rejoice the ability of trust to permeate through a decentralized network and allow you to reach consensus. Hooray! You might ask, what's the point of trusting these people? Seems arbitrary to me. Why not trust a central entity if we're handing out trust so freely? Keep in mind, these aren't the only nodes in the network. Let's say you only trust these four out of 1,000 nodes and you only want to listen to them. Of course, your follow-up question should be, if I only trust these four nodes out of thousands, how does the whole network reach consensus? This is where quorum intersections come in. By having overlapping sets of quorum slices, we can form a larger quorum and ensure consensus throughout the entire network. If all nodes share some individually selected trusted entities, then the whole network will still come to the same decisions without requiring a direct line of trust to any unknown node. You can trust popular entities with a lot of reputation, nodes which have been in the network for a while, or anyone else who you believe deserves the right to influence your decision-making. In the scenario where these quorum slices don't line up, we get what are known as disjoint quorums, the pitfall of federated consensus. If this happens, then there is no way to guarantee that all actors will come to consensus. We've talked a lot about consensus in theory. How's about we go through an example? Let's say that Rusty, Derek, and I, Nadir, are trying to figure out what to get for lunch again. But this time, our friend group is ever expanding, meaning that new people will join us during the day. Since we're nice people, we're open to letting others join. But there's always trust issues when meeting new people for the first time. Rusty suggests pizza, his favorite dish, making the suggestion to Derek and myself. We two, however, know of a secret deal for $1 burgers today. Rusty, also a fan of burgers, and also acknowledging the value of the discount, cedes to our preference and decides on burgers as well. The three of us celebrate for coming to consensus. Saroj notices our cheeriness and asks to join our friend group for lunch. However, he doesn't trust Rusty for whatever reason, perhaps because Rusty tried to get pizza on $1 burger day. Because of this, Derek and I decide to form a quorum slice with Saroj, meaning we all influence each other's decision-making. Trust is beautiful, isn't it? Gloria, seeing how much our love has flourished, also wants to join us. However, she only trusts Rusty and Derek. Rusty and Derek also trust her, so they form a quorum slice as well. And ta-da! We now have two new overlapping quorum slices with Derek in the middle. Introducing the first quorum slice, there are a total of three quorum slices. The intersections are the most crucial parts, as those ensure that decisions made within individual quorums propagate to other parts of the network.